Good morning and welcome to the Breastplate Prayer Devotional. I'm your host, Bishop Larry Jackson. Guys, we are inside of the Tent of Meetings. It is amazing. We've already looked at the structure of the Tent of Meetings and we've looked at the pillars that's there. And now it is time to deal with the furniture. Now, let me say this to you right before we start. I'm going to give you two parts dealing with this menorah. We're going to deal with the seven branch candlestick or the lampstand, it is even called. But so we're going to look at that, but it's going to be two parts. It is no way that I can actually finish all of it. So what I'm going to do while I'm talking to you today is I'm going to stop and then I'm going to keep going so that I can then keep everything going. So I'm going to look just like I am now when I come back to you on Thursday. But I want you to get this right now because I don't want to go away and come back. I don't want to lose the momentum of this teaching. So let's first go to Exodus chapter 25, verse 31 through 40 is where we're going to go. And we're talking about the seven branch candlestick. We're talking about the menorah. And it says, this is how it shall be constructed. It says, make a lampstand of pure gold. Hammer out its base and shaft and make its flower-like cups, buds and blossoms of one piece with them. Verse 32 says, six branches are to extend from the sides of the lampstand, three on one side and three on the other. Okay. Three cups shaped like almond flowers will bud and blossom and be on the one branch, three on the next branch, and the same for all six branches extending from the lamp stand. And on the lampstand are to be four cups shaped like almond flowers with buds and blossoms. Verse 35 says, on the buds shall be under the first pair of branches extending from the lampstand, a second bud under the second pair, and the third bud under the third pair. Six branches in all. 36 says, the buds and the branches shall be all of one piece with the lampstand, hammered out of pure gold. Verse 37 says, then make it seven lamps and set them up on it so that they light the space. Now notice this, in front of it. Its wick trims and trays are to be up pure gold. My goodness. A talent of gold is to be used for the lampstand and all these accessories. Excuse me. Now watch this. Exactly like the tabernacle was said, God says to Moses, see that thou make them according to the pattern showed you on the mountain. So everything was showed Moses on the mountain. This is a complete download to Moses there on Mount Sinai on how to do all of this. Now, listen, very important. The menorah was 5.3 feet tall, okay? So it was 75 pounds a talent, 75 pounds of gold was used. And this pure piece of gold is now beaten out to now be what all those pieces, all of those knobs and all of those pieces. So the amazing ability of Bezalel, who creates this, we understand that it's Bezalel that does this, this download that came into Bezalel from God, from Moses, through Moses, to understand how to build the tabernacle and all of the furniture. Amazing. God gives this in complete download. Okay. So we again know that this menorah is also known as the lampstand, also known as the candlestick or the seven branch candlestick. Now notice this as well. Neither the menorah or the brazen altar had any wood. We know that wood represents Come on, somebody should help me real quick. I should wait, let you type it in. But we don't have time. But wood represents what? Humanity. So we should understand the fact that the word of God with the brazing laver deals with in the washing and the cleansing. The word of God didn't have any, that is not talking about the human aspect of the word of God when it's talking about the word and its cleansing ability. And then we know that the menorah is speaking of the Holy Spirit. Has no human qualities. So the Holy Spirit is not human. Come on, and that makes a difference, doesn't it? Okay, that makes a difference because we're going to eventually look at that table of showbread, which is also gold, but remember, it is overlaid gold over wood. So then there means that table has something to do with humanity. Okay, now, so let's go back because we're not at the table and I don't want to get caught any kind of way. I got too much to share with you. And so here we've got the fuel of that fuels the menorah, okay? And it has to be pure olive oil, which is the same reason why we still anoint with olive oil. We anoint with olive oil because that anointing and that olive oil is connected to the Holy Spirit, and that's why we're using olive oil. And that's how they lit the menorah, because they had to have pure, though. It had to be pure olive oil. So let's go to Exodus chapter 27, and let's look at verse 20. And it says, "And thou shalt command the children of Israel that they bring three pure olive oil," my God, oils of olive, "beaten for the light." And so the olives were beaten for the light to cause the lamp to burn, listen to this, always. So in the tabernacle of the congregation with the veil, which is before the testimony, Aaron and his son shall order it from evening to morning before the Lord. It shall be a statue forever unto their generations on the behalf of the children of Israel. This is amazing too, because again, using from the evening to the morning is the exact same way, is the exact same way that God says that he created everything. And the evening and the morning was the first day. And so from the evening, the lighting of the menorah in the evening, and it burned to the morning. And now it was cleansed so that it can burn continually in the morning. But this is Aaron and his sons that is administrating this. Now, okay? So now the only light, let's get this for a moment. The only light is the light emitting from the menorah. There is no other light. Remember, we talked about all of the coverings over the tent of meetings. There is no roof, but all of these coverings give it its roof, these four layers, which we've already talked about. And so therefore, these layers are so thick and so dense that no light can come through. And these layers overlay on even the side, so the board there can have any light that will seep through. And so it is pitch black in the place except for the light of the menorah. And so here, this is an awesome picture, but the light is reflecting off of all of the gold in the place. It's shining directly from the south side of the tent of meetings to the north side, where the south side is where the menorah is positioned, and the table of shewbread, again, that we mentioned earlier, is on the north side of the tabernacle, okay, or the tent of meetings, and or the camp, okay. So the south and the north side. So you got that, and then the light is shining over onto that table that represents Jesus as the bread of life. Oh my God! So the Holy Spirit, light, if you will, is now functioning to now show us Jesus and his supply. Okay, again, so let's keep going. The seven branches, again, can be connected to the 7 days of creation, but I connect them to Jesus. Why? Because Jesus said, again, it can be, it's not a problem to have in 7 days, but when you connect it to Jesus, you see something. Because Jesus said another comforter, or one like himself, would come to lead the disciples and the church into all truth. Let's find that. We find that in St. John chapter 14, verse 16. He says, "And I pray the Father, and he give you shall give you another comforter that shall that he may be with you how long? Forever. Okay. Then in verse 26 of the same chapter, chapter 14 of St. John, he says, but the comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, you see, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you. So now he is the illumination of everything. He is the one that's lighting everything, and he's getting you to see the way that Jesus wants you to see. We go to St. John chapter 15, verse 26. But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceeded from the Father, he shall testify of me. So where are we, ladies and gentlemen? Where are we? We have come through the doorway of the tabernacle into what? A new level, which is called the truth. We've come there, and he is the light and the Spirit of truth. Hallelujah. So we've come into the truth because Jesus says, I'm the way, I am the truth. And so as we come through the truth, he's now the Spirit of truth. Let's look at one more scripture. St. John chapter 16, verse 7. It says, likewise, I tell you the truth. It's expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, he said, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. So the Holy Spirit is the one who has come to lead and to guide us into all the truth and to tell us what Jesus told us so that we will never forget who we are and where we are and whose we are. Now, I'm telling you guys, I got so much. I told you, I said, look, I'm going to go right into the second part and then I'll broadcast it on Thursday. But where I am now in this teaching, I can promise you, I'm going to have to sit here probably two more sessions so that I can get all this out. It probably will be three now, and I will not do anything. I'm not going to lose this momentum in talking to you. And so I'm going to stop this, and I'm going to go right back into this and record it so that I don't want to miss anything. Now, let me say this to you. If you have learned something, if you are being blessed by this, share this teaching so somebody else can catch up. Right now is a good place for people to get involved with us in this time, because we are in the place that I'm telling you, the majority of the church, even though they're filled with the Spirit, even though they speak in other tongues, they are not living in this place. And I promise you, I'm going to help you to understand how to live here and to live in the light of the Spirit of God. God bless you. Hey, don't forget to visit my website, bishoplarryjackson.com. I love you so much. God bless you. Have a great one. Bye-bye.